Welcome to Linux in a Shell, episode 31, Who Command. My name is Dan Washko. I'll be your host. As always, I'd like to thank Hacker Public Radio for hosting the website and the show's audio file. So if you haven't already read the episode notes or listen to the audio, I suggest you do so over at www.linuxinashell.org to get the full write-up, as this is only the examples. As I said in the write-up, the Who command simply shows who's logged into the system and where they're logged in from. You notice that here I have logged into a virtual console at TTTY1, and I also have a few xterm sessions open, are all on sudo terminals right here, PTS 0, 1, 2, and 0, 1, and 2. So that's, if I go over to here, I'm over a virtual terminal. If I close this one and I go back in there and type who again, you'll see that I've lost one of my terminals. Now, who can show other things, like it could show dead processes. That is processes that the init command had spawned. And you see there that that terminal that I closed is now a dead process with the -d option right there. So that's pretty helpful. Also, if you type who b, it shows you the last time the system boot occurred, which was fairly recently because I had a power outage today at the old house there. If you're not sure as to what the, you know, when you do headings here, what the columns mean, you can use the capital H to see the column headings. So you see there fully in tells you the name of the user in the first column. Second column is the line, which is where they're logged in from, like a terminal. Time is when they logged in, and comment is where they actually logged in from. So if I was in like here on a remote session and I typed who, you would see that I'm logged in on this server from a different host name right there and my internal network. So there you go. I can do who and pass it the M right there, and it shows me the same thing as like who am I right there, or who am I right there, or who-m all tell me which user I am currently running under and where I'm logged in as. Who am I with the who-r should tell me to run level, but that one doesn't tell me what it is. Over here, it shows me I'm run level 3. And I think that's one of those things, because my run level is specified, I'm not using init. And this is Slackware. That's using init. This is Arch, and that's using systemd. So some of the things may not show exactly as you would expect them to at this time because of the differences between initd and system, initd and systemd. Init and systemd, not initd. Who-t shows the last time the system clock changed. Neither of those have it listed there. So I haven't changed the system clock in a while, that who is able to record it. The -u just shows users logged in, and also shows their login time, idle time. So if I do who-hu, you see that right here, it added a couple of columns here. One was idle time, and that showed that this idle has been no activity in the past hour and 52 seconds, whereas these terminals both have had activity within the past minute. And then it shows the terminal PID. So if I did PSEF grep 224, you see that's the login shell for right there, 224, and it spawned there. If I did PSEF grep 470, you would see that that is another login right there. That's my pseudo terminal running in the console session. So that's some information right there. You can type who-t or who-message to see who has messages. So if I were to do message y and do who-t, you see now that has a plus on it. So if I were to run a message or send a message to the user, I could, as because that's turned on, a standard user could, whereas only root would be able to message the person that doesn't have it turned on. So if you were to need to send a message to somebody, you could do that message command, display or display, tells it to display or not display messages by other users. That's the message command right there. So if I wanted to, I could, let's see, let me switch this terminal here. So if I were to talk, Dan, hello, and that's not really going to do it for me. If I were to write, getting beyond here. So if I were to write, what am I at here? This is PTS, PTS 1. So if I do write, Dan, PTS 1, PTS slash 1. Oh. Whoops. Why? Ah. Hello. And see, it says there, and I say, oh, hello. Oh, I gotta do right. Dan, Pete. Let me go in here and write Dan PTS slash 2. Hello back at ya. And I go back there and it says hello back at ya. Right. And there we go. So that's just writing back and forth. Going beyond what I wanted to show, but there we go. What else is there? Who-P shows any active init processes. Right there, I have one. PSEF grep 1980 shows SSVC boot. That's SVSC scan is part of that there. So those are active init processes that are running. I don't have any active init processes that are running on this other server. If I were to do who-q, which is a count, counts only, lists only the users that are logged in and then gives you a total, whereas right here I should only get one right there on that server because that's the only one that's logged in right there. Who-h, who-hs for short. You notice that it really doesn't show any differences. Short prints only name, line, and time. It's the defaults. It's the same thing as showing just who. So I showed you there that what it shows, the essentially the defaults right there. That is pretty much who in a nutshell. Another thing I could show you is who-ha. Well, who-a right there. Who-a doesn't is like an all command. So if I were to do who-ha, it shows you everything. It's equivalent to who-b for boot, the last system boot, dash d for any dead processes, dash login, which shows you the login processes. I didn't show you that one before. Who-login shows you if there's any terminals that are in a login state that are spawned by init. And again, this is a systemd, and let me just erase this and show you right here a different system. Systemd is not, who's not picking up that there are terminals that I could log into, but who over here in init is, there's six terminals that are spawned, seven terminals that are spawned, well, 6 terminals that are spawned that are in a login ready state. These are the virtual terminals spawned by the init process. So again, with the dash A is equivalent to B for boot, last boot time, D for any dead processes, login for those terminals, P, which is for any active processes spawned by init, R is for the current run level, T is for time, which is the last time change, capital T is to show message status, am I right on that, message status, yes, and dash U is to show any users that are still logged in. So if I do that, I get the full output there. Looks exactly like it did up there before. The only thing is missing is the headers. Whereas if I did the same thing here, I get not as verbose output due to just the state of the system and not running a full-fledged init as opposed to systemd. That is who in a nutshell. Head on over to the website for further explanation of these. I could also show you, you can do a different, specify the file you want to read. It does the utemp file by default, but I could do varlog wtemp, which is a historical information. You get that same information right there, but shows you everything that happened in the past, in the previously, gives dates and idle times and who was logged in the past. It's almost the same as same information that you would get from running the last command, although last is a little more verbose in different things. So that's the who command. Thanks a lot. Remember, head on over to the website, linuxinashell.org, for the full skinny. Have a great one.